Hello and welcome to the online learning session, KNX Switch Actuators Applications with ETS Programming. Yeah, our online learning sessions take around 30 minutes, so focuses on a special topic, on a special product. Today I will go into some more details of the ETS programming with the new KNX Switch Actuators, and I've made here a special project for you. Yeah, my name is Thorsten Reibel from the ABB Competence Center Europe, Smart Buildings, and my colleagues Jürgen Schilder and Martin Bichari, they are also in their home offices, and I will do right now or today. The session will be recorded and also later published, so you get as always a feedback email together with a video and also the presentation. So you see the RCC Europe here in their home offices, myself, Jürgen, Martin and also Stefan doing the technical support. Yeah, our mission at the moment is working from the home office to you. I think many of you work also in the home offices. So we're doing a lot of online learning sessions, but also webinars in the next time. Later I will come to the next topics we are going to do in the next time. Yeah, but let's come to our topic today. So it's very simple. We talk about the ETS application, but not as I did already on Tuesday. Do not go into all parameters. I have created directly in the ETS a project. I will go now very soon in the ETS itself and show you in the software how I've have programmed some solutions which have to do with safety functions and forced operation with scenes. The threshold function I'm using here, as well as a staircase function, and also the flashing, so lights switched on and off in special situation. Very few slides today only. The main part is directly in the ETS, but nevertheless, I have still three slides at the end dealing with the topic switching of DC, direct current loads, three-phase loads, and also LED lamps. Some small information for you. I think this fits today in this online learning session. We are talking about our relatively new switch actuators split into three types or three families, the combi switch actuator, standard and professional. You see on the left the combi version. This has also shutter functionality. This part, shutter functionality in the combi switch actuator, I will do in the beginning of June in a separate session. And we have here the standard switch actuator and the professional ones. The functions I'm showing today are possible with all these components. The software is more or less the same, except the shutter functionality here in the combi switch actuator and some parameters regarding the manual operation, which is also a bit different here. But we have done this already in some other webinars, and also on Tuesday we're talking about a bit in the last online learning session. So today I have created an ETS project, and let me first of all explain what is behind this project, which functions are behind, before I then go directly into the ETS and show it directly there. So we have here a so-called event hall with some lighting, and this lighting is not controlled with the switch actuators, but with a DALI gateway. But the lights here in the entrance area and also the exit light next to the doors are controlled via switch actuators. And of course, a light with DALI can be dimmed. And one situation is that if you dim down the light in the event hall, and if you undershoot a certain level, then both the exit light and also the entrance light has to be switched on due to safety reasons, that it's not too dark in this area here around. So this is one condition we have to fulfill. So depending on dimming, we can turn on the light first of all, but also off if we have very high brightness here in the event hall. The lights in the entrance area has a so-called staircase function, so normally switch off after a certain time if nobody is walking there anymore. But of course, if the light has to be turned on due to low dimming brightness here in the hall, then the staircase lighting is not active, only continuous light has to be turned on here. We have different central functions. There is a central function which turns off all lights with higher priority than any local operation. So if I switch off everything, nobody can turn on anymore. And a further, even higher priority switching is in case of fire alarm. So we connect any fire alarm system to our KNX system. And in case of fire alarm, we would like to turn on all lights. And yeah, with highest priority, so nobody can turn it off anymore. So we work here with different priority levels. And all these functions can be done directly in the switch actuators. And we use the switch actuator with a threshold function, safety priority functions we have inside, so-called forced operation, and the staircase function. So let's have a look in the ETS how it is programmed. So in principle, I concentrate on the switch actuator and here also on the DALI gateway we use here as well. The sensors behind are not so important. How you control this can be any push buttons or any touch panels. Even presence detectors could be here in use for the entrance area, for example. This is not my topic. So I share with you now my laptop screen. You see now the ETS. What did I program in the ETS here? I have split this in three components. So the basic functions we are doing right now is in this component here, the switch actuator, combi switch actuator, but it's independent of the new switch actuator. The function is the same. I have a DALI gateway premium for the lighting in the event hall. A three-tone push button, it's only for my testing here, so of course what I've done here is not only theory, it's practice. I have checked everything, but that's properly working. And then later we come to other functions which I have additionally programmed into other switch actuators. So we need two switch actuator channels, switch actuator A and B. A is the entrance area with a staircase lighting, and switch actuator channel B is linked to the exit lights I've just mentioned. So what do we do? We have to configure. First of all, I have configured here in my case four outputs, so at the moment I need only two, A and B, and I have programmed here a so-called logic threshold function, so I need one logic out of 24 which are available here, and it's practically later this threshold function I will explain. So then we have programmed some safety functions, and I use a safety priority one function for this fire alarm, which the highest priority I can turn on all lights. We have two others available, safety priority 2 and 3. I don't use it here, so not enabled. So then I go to, these are the channel independent parameters I have changed here, and then I go to switch actuator A, where I have to program staircase lighting because it's the entrance area light, so I need staircase lighting. And I have to enable also these safety functions because I will use it for these turning on of the light due to fire alarm. So basic settings, in principle nothing here necessary, but safety. So my safety priority one, fire alarm, results in an on command to turn on the light with highest priority, so I adjust it here. And the second, also safety function, so-called forced operation, I use as well for switching off all lamps. So it's a command off here. And the priority of safety priority one is higher than forced operation. That's the order here. If I would have enabled also priority two and three, it will be below the forced operation. So this I need as well. And then I need the staircase lighting. Because it's the entrance area. I have parameterized only 5 seconds here for testing, and it's a standard staircase lighting, so no additional features like re-triggering or pump up the staircase time to have a longer staircase time. All these things I don't need here. Yeah, switch actuator B needs also the priority switching because it's also in case of fire alarm and for central switch off involved, but no time function. I need no staircase function here. So basic setting, nothing special, and safety again, like the entrance area here, the same on and off, on for fire alarm or for central off function. So that's in principle programmed here. In the parameters, let's have a look to the group object. And I show you also the group addresses I have created. You don't see it here. So never mind, I will explain then what is behind. So starting with channel A, the switch actuator, so I can operate it locally, whatever it means, not so important at the moment. Here is the forced operation, means central off. It's 1012. It belongs not only to channel A but also channel B, and it comes from anywhere to switch off with higher priority than the local switching all the lights. So then allow me to come first of all to these threshold functions. What did I program? But maybe I show this again in the parameters. So LOTSIG threshold, of course we need this as well. This is here. I did not show this up to now, but I will do this right now. So I have programmed here the threshold. In my case, if the brightness of the DALI lighting in the event hall is undershooting 30%, then I would like to turn on exit light and entrance area light on command here. If I overshoot 70% in my case, then it will be turned off, zero here. This is my programming. You can adjust these thresholds, of course. Yeah, and you see I've also programmed here a minimum duration of overshooting and undershooting. So if the time or the overshooting undershooting is only a short time, then I don't take action only for a longer time. So this you can adjust here as well. Coming back to the group objects. So this is my logic here. So the input, threshold input, is the brightness status of my DALI lighting group I have programmed here, and I get directly as a 1 byte object the information. So if I undershoot then 30%, I send out the result out of this threshold of this comparison 140, and I will send it then directly to turn on permanently the entrance area. So I don't use a switch object, which is staircase lighting behind. No, I switch on permanently with a permanent on group object. So the light won't go off automatically anymore. That's what I want. And the same for channel B, the exit light. So and then we have the safety priority 1 here. This is the group address 1011 coming from any fire alarm system. So how do you do this practically? A fire alarm system normally is not a KNX system behind, so no direct connection to KNX possible. But one simple way would be using binary input, so the alarm contact of the alarm system, fire alarm system linked to a binary input, and then they have the information alarm yes or no, or even better using our security terminal from the security solutions we have. There you have also the option to monitor the wiring, so it's a real security input, let's say. But finally, the same result is a 1-bit telegram. I get the information alarm, yes or no. Yeah, this alarm comes with safety priority 1. And as I have programmed in the parameters, I come back to this. Go on if safety priority 1 is active, both for channel A and B. Yes, the same. Yeah, in this case, automatic light will be turned on and with highest priority, and nobody can switch off. So that's the programming here. If I come to the DALI gateway, only a small look. I've programmed not so much here. I've used only one DALI group with some lights behind, which can be operated as well. You see here, here is a brightness value status feedback used for the comparison with the threshold. I can turn on the light here as well. Ah, that's in principle the function. And of course, I have tested everything. By the way, I will give you, of course, also this ETS project. No problem. You will get it later with a feedback email. This function is done. Not that much, but some features you have to know. We can extend our solution here by doing the following. We would like to have additionally light scenes, and both our KNX switch actuators but also our DALI gateways are very powerful also in terms of creating light scenes or scenes at all. So here I would like to have 3 scenes, sowohl the light in the hall but also the exit light and the entrance light is involved with different values. And I use a scene functionality both in the switch actuator and also the DALI gateway. It's the same, the so-called 1-byte Light scene management we can do there, but to operate or to recall the scenes, I would like to have not only these one byte objects where you have the information recall or storing the scene and the scene number, but I would like to have a simple one bit object to activate each scene, which is in both devices as well possible. I show you directly in the ETS. I have here selected now another component. We have added also this scene functionality. So I go directly here. So the former functions are still existing, but as an add-on, you will find here now further group objects, further parameterization for scenes. You see it here. Some object, additional objects for scenes, 6 in total. Well, I can sort this here. Well, let's maybe do it here. Not really better, but you see it here, scene 1, 2, 3, scene 1, 2, 3 was a different two channels here, individual one-bit objects. But let's go first of all to the parameters, which is very simple. You activate here the scene functionality per channel. So output A and output B, I use it. And then you get here fine further parameter, page, scene assignment. And you create up to 16 scenes are possible. One scene after another you can create here. You see enable scene assignment 4 at the bottom here can create more scenes, but let's concentrate on the scenes I've done already. So number 1 and scene number, function on. Scene number 2 also on, and scene number 3 it's off. Of course, a switch actuator can only have an on or off function in a scene. I have activated here a so-called delay, so you can also, the function behind this channel can be operated delayed. The good thing is here, if I adjust a small time, 1 second in my case, I also deactivate any staircase lighting or switching on off delay, which of course I want, because a scene should not be deactivated automatically after the staircase time, for this channel at least. So if I say at least 1 second here, then the staircase lighting is deactivated. That's what I want to have. Yeah, and you see here, scene recall also via group object. If I enable this here, then this one bit object appears, and not only the one byte object, which we have as well available. I don't use it here. Scene 1 to 64, 1 byte, but I use here only the individual group addresses or group objects appearing for recall scene assignment 1, 2, 3 for channel A, the same for channel B here. Now you see it's more group address assignment, but easier maybe with one bit for any push button or whatever you have. But of course, it's also possible here for the one byte object. Those options you have. Back to our project. So this is an additional feature required. And last but not least, one more to show you what is additionally possible. Maybe later there will be installed an alarm system, intrusion alarm system. In case of any intrusion, in case of intrusion alarm, all lights shall flash. So an additional, let me say, alarming inside the building, on and off and change. This has to be programmed. We have the so-called flashing function, our switch actuators. It's available as a further time function, but the challenge at the moment is if you have used already staircase function and we use it already in channel A for the entrance area, cannot have a second, in this case, flashing function anymore. And the DALI gateway, all lights have to flash, not only here exit and entrance area, but also in the hall itself. It has no flashing function at all in the software available. So what is the solution? We use free output in the switch actuator we hopefully have, so an unused channel which has not any circuit behind, but we program here the flashing function, and we can program as well a status telegram, a status feedback from the switch actuator channel, and this status as a telegram on the bus gives us the information is light on and off, and if we have a flashing function it changes from on to off and vice versa. So a real status of the relay position in principle is behind this group object. Yeah, and this I assign to the other channels, A and B, and also to the DALI gateway, and then it works as a kind of logic for or intelligence for flashing light. Let's have a look to the ETS. Let's go to the parameters first of all. And I use channel C here. That's the reason why I enabled also channel C and D here as a second block. And I go there to channel C, or switch actuator channel C, flashing. So function, first of all, you have to enable here the time function. And this is only the choice between the three we have, staircase, delay on and off, and flashing, or no. So I use flashing here, and then this additional parameter page appears. Yeah, and then I decide how to do. So I have to send an on telegram to start the flashing, and the time for on and off. Can adjust here in hours, minutes, seconds. In my case, I use 2 seconds on, 2 seconds off, but the minimum time is 1 second. And the number of flashes you can adjust here as well, it's limited to 100. And you see an additional, let me say, information. We have all the time here in this ETS application to give you some important information or sometimes a link or a hint to go to another parameters page to adjust there something. Observe the contact life and switching cycle per minute, because it's a mechanical on and off, and of course not endless possible. But in case of alarm, that's not very often happening, hopefully it's not a problem. So flashing is active. Then I go back to the group object, channel C. One more. Finally, I have to enable here this feedback under basic setting, feedback of contact position via group object status switch. Yes, I need this. So the real information, contact open or close. And yeah, if my intrusion alarm comes in with a telegram, maybe the same like the fire detection system via binary input or a security terminal, then I start flashing, and with the status, this group address, 1313, I switch on and off channel B and A, both lights I have connected here, 1313, 1313, here is a group address, as well as in the DALI gateway. I use it here as well. This is also possible. So, yeah, that's all, and the function is working. Good, so this is my program here, an example. You can adapt this, what is possible, and all is done with the integrated functionality of the switch actuator. Good, again, you get this ETS project as an additional help together with my online learning session. Maybe it helps you anywhere in a project. Okay, so then I have three other small topics for the end of this online learning session. I would like to explain a bit. It has to do with switching of different kind of loads and situations, let's say. I start switch actuator and DC load, direct current, which is not very often, but comes more and more. Typically, of course, we have any alternating current AC load behind, which is standard. But in some projects, low voltage DC networks are coming or are required. Whatever you have, from 5 volt to maybe 12, 40, 24, or 48 volt, but I have heard also of 230 volt networks, DC networks. And advantage is if you have low voltage networks, you have now more and more low voltage consumers in the building, and you save, of course, energy in case or due to the fact that you don't need any transformer, any power supplies. And this is a topic for green buildings sometimes. Yeah, maybe it comes in the future more that we have less classical 230 volt or whatever 120 volt socket outlets in a building, but more low voltage outputs. So what is a challenge? A challenge is switching, also if you would like to switch on and off these loads as well with our switch actuators. Challenge is especially the switch off of inductive direct current loads. Because what does it mean if you switch off an inductive DC load? The current does not stop flowing immediately. You might have an electrical or electric arc, and this of course is affecting the performance or the lifespan of the contacts of the relays. Yeah? Can burn the relay contacts and destroy finally the relays and the switch actuator behind. Yeah. With AC it's a bit easier because we have an alternating current, or, and what does it mean? In the sinusoidal curve, you have very soon the cross zero crossing of the voltage, so automatically you extinguish then the arc in this case, which we do not have with DC. So what is the consequence here? Our switch actuators can operate DC voltage, it's possible, but the higher the voltage is, the lower is the current you can run over such a contact. So we give you at least information concerning 24 volt DC. And you see an example, our technical data for the professional switch actuator, it can handle 20 ampere, this 24 volt, but resistive load. Yeah. And if you again increase the voltage, and then you have this 230 volt, a few milliampere only left. Yeah. So this is very important, and it should be taken into consideration if you have such a load. Of course, what is always possible, you say, okay, too risky, I don't do this. I use an additional DC capable relay, which is made for DC switching, and then I have my load behind. And then, of course, our switch actuator is only here controlling, operating the control circuit of the relay, which is no current. There's no current behind. Principle, yes, possible, but be careful what you are doing here, and please check whether it's possible. So DC loads, then three-phase loads is also a topic sometimes to operate these three-phase loads directly with three relays in parallel from our switch actuators. You can say, okay, no problem. I connect here my three-phase load. I link the same group address to all three outputs, and then I operate these three relays together to operate the three-phase load. In principle, yes, but for some loads, it's very important that the three phases will be operated at the same time with no delay. Take a motor, a three-phase motor. Absolutely necessary. Of course, if you have an oven, thermal load, I think no problem to have a small delay between operating the three phases. Even with this three-phase light bend, this is not a critical situation. But a motor especially is critical. And we cannot guarantee with our switch actuators that we operate with central commands or with three, also even with three relays, all relays at the same time. This is not possible. Maybe you remember this if you operate in a multi-channel device, all relays together, you hear and sometimes you see also a delay in operation, let's say, of all relays together. So also here, finally, if you have to solve it for sure and don't want to take any risk, of course you take any insulation contactor in between. Again, you operate via our switch actuator only the control circuit here, and then a real contactor, three-phase contactor, which guarantees parallel or simultaneous operation of three outputs, and then you connect your three-phase load. This is also something that, even if you have high currents needed here, high power, which you cannot handle with our relays here anymore, then of course you have to take also such a contactor behind. Okay, then finally another, more and more common load, LED lights, of course, it's more and more common, everybody knows this. And for energy efficient lighting, of course, a topic. What is good for us, that normally the power of an LED lighting is compared with conventional lighting and the same brightness, lower. The efficiency, of course, is here behind. So practically, we have lower LED power behind than compared with conventional lighting. But also here, it's challenging to switch on LED loads because here you have typically these high inrush currents if you switch on an LED load. There's an electronic behind, there's a capacitive behavior behind, and if you turn on a capacity, then you have a high starting current, inrush current, and of course this has to be handled also by the relay contacts. So this is higher than using any conventional lamps, halogen lamps, whatever, with LEDs. So, of course, you have low power, lower power behind. But nevertheless, you need an information what can be connected. And I hope, I think you know our selection tables for the switch actuators, showing you yeah, a lot of information about the relay hardware, the current switch loads can be connected depending on the load type. And also we added here for these new switch actuators, the load LED lamps slash energy saving lamp. Here on the right, I have made a copy from this selection table. And you see for the combi switch actuators, we have maximum 250 watt for LED lamps possible, per channel of course. And for standard 400, these are the three standard switch actuators here. And on the right side, it's a professional. The best relay in terms of power, 650 watt is possible. So that's less than if you look to the halogen lamp or bulb performance. But okay, I think in many cases absolutely sufficient, but don't forget this, keep this in mind as well. If you have to connect higher power or many LED lamps in parallel to one channel output. Okay, so three more information to regarding these special loads. Then I show as always my last slides. So of course you find on our homepage everything related to our products, so product manuals for all our components, giving you also a lot of information. We have our training database. We store all our sessions, also online sessions we are doing right now, both as yeah, PDF file, but also the video. Also this one will be stored there very soon. But don't forget, you get also a feedback email as always, direct with the links. We have our training and qualification calendar, showing all our activities around trainings, which is of course a bit less due to not existing classroom trainings. We hope, we think, we will see that we can continue the next or the second half of this year with real local trainings in Heidelberg, in Lüdenscheid, or anywhere in the world. We will see. Still in our mind are the certified trainings starting already in July, the next parts, October, November. Advanced tutor basic course. We will decide very soon whether it's possible to run these sessions, and we keep you informed here during our online activities what's going on there. So, and last slide, preview to what is coming in the next future, at least regarding the online learning sessions. So next week Jürgen is coming in with yeah, nice but special topic: temperature control of a barbecue smoker with KNX. Not the daily business of KNX, of course, but a good example to show the performance of KNX, not only for temperature control. There is more behind. You will see measurement of high temperatures, fan speed control, remote access, and more. And I think a nice different online learning session has to do with different products, of course, in KNX. And on Thursday, the 4th of June, I will come back to the combi switch actuator, but then only shutter functions. I think I will do it not only in ETS, I'd create also a project and combine both within half an hour. More will follow. We are happy if you give us feedback what you would like to have as a content. You can send us directly to our email any information or any proposals. But also we have here an email address from our RCC training. So we will take it, we will evaluate it. We have already got some feedbacks, and we will see what's possible. But for sure we will continue in the next time with these yeah, shorter online learning sessions, beside of course the webinars. Yeah. So webinars we have also already now, the next one comes in beginning of June also, or 10th of June. But here we'll get additional information. I say thank you for your participation. Yeah, hope to see you next week with this nice topic here, barbecue smoker. Thank you for your participation. See you next time. Bye-bye. Ciao.